Hey, what's up, guys? Today I want to share with you some important topic that I think I haven't talked in length with most of you guys. I just made this tweet and I got quite a number of responses in my DM. People asking, probably I've been doing this, am I on the right path? What do I need to do to achieve this within this short period or within this specific time frame? So I think I want to share what I meant, and there's an image here, and this image is basically illustrating what basically happens, or the shortcut basically that you can do. And this applies to almost everyone in every capacity. In most cases, you find we have guys who are moving from other fields coming to GIS, or we have GIS guys who've just started and they want to know how to venture or get into development. So the image here is a bit simplistic in terms of the steps or the processes that you need to achieve. And whatever I've shared here, it's a bit more of an introductory. So you need to dig in and understand what each of the steps mean. So I'll do an elaboration of what is contained in this image, and then I'll be able to explain bit by bit what I mean and what are some of the things that you can do. The first thing, as you can see on the far left, is basically having the basics. So I know there are guys who have come from other fields, for example IT, and they want to get into GIS development, but then you find that along the way they get stuck because either someone does not understand the basics of GIS, or when dealing with this data set, some elements are a bit confusing because you never got the basics. So in my view, it's best to start from the basics, and this is a bit simplistic. This is learning, understanding what is GIS in a nutshell, knowing the type of data sets that GIS deals with, the type of processes or workflows that are contained within this paradigm. And then, of course, overall is learning the various software that exist in this sector. So within the GIS industry, we have like a listing of a number of software that exist. But of course, we have those that are popular and others that are still picking up the pace. And the most popular ones are ArcGIS and QGIS. We have others like Supermap. We have things like MapWindow. We have OpenJump. We have GrassGIS. All these are software that have various functionality when dealing with a GIS dataset, or basically when carrying out various analysis within the scope. So when you understand what happens within the GIS industry, what are the software, what are the data sets, it becomes a bit easier, and you also understand, or you are able to know what really happens when it comes to the different bits within the industry. When you understand what really happens within the different components within the basics level, then you are good to go, because at that level you are able to understand the differences between raster files, vector files, what are attribute data set, data, what is metadata. And then if you are to display some data set within an application, you really know that you need a certain attribute that showcases this kind of information. So that is one thing that is ignored by most developers when starting out. And I think it's a crucial element that we need to consider when planning or when starting out as a your GIS career. Then the other bit is, of course, the programming skills. In this level, you are quite familiar with what a GIS is, what happens there, what are the software, what are the processes and everything. Now, programming skills, this is for everyone again, because you cannot really say that you're developing an application, either it's a web application or a desktop application or mobile application, without knowing about programming languages or programming frameworks or programming like the modules, libraries and all that. So you need to understand, or you need to acquire these skills, because they will be helpful in coming up with the entire ecosystem. So for example, if you want to show a GIS portal, you know that you will either require JavaScript for the front end, you require some CSS for the styling, you require probably some a backend of some sort, which probably it's either in Python or Java or any kind of language that you're interested with or you're already familiar with. So coupling that with the basics that you already learned in the previous step, with the programming now, this is open. If you're planning to go the mobile way, you probably learn a different kind of language. You'll probably find someone learning Kotlin, or you're learning Swift, or you're learning Python, or it's R, or it's Java. That is your own choosing. But I always advise people, because most of the GIS software are based on Python, and most of the statistics of today, you find some, most of the frameworks or most of the libraries that are out there probably are in R. You can basically focus on Python and R and Java for huge or robust enterprise solutions, because Java is powerful. It's an awesome language. So if you, for example, want to learn or want to understand about dealing with a lot of raster files or raster datasets within your applications, then serving that data, you'll find some applications that are based in Java that are superbly awesome. That is an example, GeoServer. Then from there, the guys who probably want to remain or want to go the desktop GIS way, so you find yourself developing plugins either for QGIS or ArcGIS. You want to write some automation scripts. These are basically very, very okay. And you'll find that you want to enhance your productivity. There you can learn quite a lot when it comes to customizing existing software. And this is in regard to your workflow. So there's someone who probably has a good understanding of ArcGIS or QGIS and want to develop these plugins, then with the programming skills, you comfortably do that and you'll be able to achieve your solution. For guys who are going the web GIS way, of course, you can combine, you can learn using these steps. You can also combine quite a number of things. Personally, for the years I've learned or have been using Python over time, in some cases I've been using R, and for some applications, I find myself using Java. So there's no silver bullet when it comes to the programming languages. Of course, you need to understand what you want to do and what you want to basically achieve when it comes to your career. So you can learn either of the languages or either of the platforms. That is for you to choose. Then, after that, you are now having two super skills. One, you understand the basics of GIS, and two, you can comfortably program or you can comfortably code. So now it's time to develop your applications. And as I mentioned before, GIS applications can be of different levels. Of course, there's someone going to the web side of things. There's a person who is going to the mobile side of things, and then there's this person who is going to the desktop. So within all that, these are applications. You can develop your own custom applications. Other people will focus on customizing existing software. So again, that is depending on your workflow or depending on what you want to achieve. But at this level, once you have the basics of GIS and the programming skills, you can comfortably go to developing GIS applications. So here, for you to basically learn more, you can develop applications day in, day out. You can learn through coding. You can also read a lot of code that is there. Most nowadays, with the GitHub repositories or either of the versioning tools that are out there, you can basically find a project that was developed. You could actually track its timelines. You could see the steps that these guys took to develop the solution, and you can actually learn from that. The other thing is contributing to open source software or projects. This is another way of gaining skills, because at the third step, this is where you're gaining massive, massive skills. And these are the skills that will lead you, or basically you'll be using in the industry to offer solutions to clients or to partners. So here at this level, you want to have as much skills as you can. Of course, in GIS, there's this saying of GIS is limited to the user's thinking, which is very, very true. Over years, I've seen that to be true. So you could actually contribute to an open source project, which is even not related to GIS, but you are there to gain skills, your development skills. You could also develop your own applications, look for a problem within your community or within your locality, come up with a plan to solve the problem, develop an application to sort out that. So it could be a tracker, it could be an inventory system, it could be a monitoring system. That is for you to decide. But of course, do something. Even if you are working a daily job or you have a project that you're already working on, you could probably have side projects which could help you gain more skills as you go by. Okay, and then the green bit here, I put them in green on purpose because it shows like more of the success zone. And having gone through the three phases, you find yourself you find opportunities out there which you can leverage and basically work on. And the other thing is basically the kind of learning that you've done through the three steps, it doesn't end there. Of course, every day we are having new libraries coming out, new frameworks, new languages, new systems. Of course, you have to keep yourself updated with the daily or the day-to-day updates that are happening within the industry. So it's a matter of you knowing where you want to focus your efforts on and knowing where you basically want to go. And then, of course, you'll find so much that is happening. Today, we have a lot of research going on. Academia has really improved when it comes to research. There are so many libraries, so many frameworks coming out. Guys are really doing some amazing stuff. And with the networks that you've developed over time, that's the way we have networking as an umbrella of the three steps. It's because at every stage, networking should never stop. So even if you know what is a GIS software, you know ArcGIS and then QGIS, you're not supposed to say that, I know so little, so I'm not going to network with industry guys because probably they will see as if I don't understand much of it. But no, networking is a non-ending kind of process. It's more of a skill. There are some guys who attend conferences and you find someone very quiet on a certain corner. Another person is talkative. Another person is showcasing things here and there. Be that proactive individual, because at the end of the day, if you keep quiet with your solutions or your skills, no one will actually know what you know. So it's through sharing, it's through networking, it's through presentations that you find an audience to your solutions or to your skills, and this is how you are able to connect yourself to opportunities. So of course, it's not everything that is shown here doesn't come on a silver platter. It's kind of some work. There are some people who will take weeks to accomplish this, others will take months, others will take years. So it's for you to plan. But the easiest of it all is knowing what you need to do, coming up with a plan and starting. Yeah. So of course, there are those elements that I've always talked about in my blogs or in my posts, things to do with consistency, things to do with persistency, things to do with having that drive to learn as much as you can within a short period, because when you're starting out, time is not your friend. Of course, there are those guys who've already achieved those skills before you, but that doesn't mean you stop. It means you need to start and get moving. So you can actually do a lot of research. You can learn from online resources. You can actually read a lot of blogs, read a lot of code from repositories, and it's a process. And at the end of the day, you'll see the the fruits. I know there are some things that I've not captured here, such as certifications and all that. I don't think they are that important in today's world. I've seen people focus more on acquiring certification or getting certificates for the various courses or lectures or whatever kind of gathering they've been to. But the most important thing is getting the skill set itself. So it can be kind of embarrassing having a certification for probably web development that you cannot even develop a simple application. But imagine someone who can develop an application, but they don't have the certification. That person probably will get better faster and quickly than someone who has certification but cannot show for it. This is a technical field. In most cases, people or industries, organizations will pick guys with the technical skills, but that does not, of course, eliminate the aspect that you need not to understand things to do with communication, business, and everything. When you're a developer, all those should be within your scope. You should be able to grasp them quite well. Don't go to a meeting, just showcase your solution and then keep quiet. Just be able to narrate the story. Explain what happened here, what is this solution doing, what problem is it solving, who is it tailored for. And by that, you'll be able to actually connect more with the clients or more with the partners, possible partners that you can work with on the solution. So that is it, guys. I'm open to questions. I'm open to comments and inquiry. If you have anything that you need to ask, just do it below there in the comment section, and I'll be glad to answer. And I want to wish everyone well who's starting out, or someone who probably is starting this GIS development journey. Find someone who can be more of your mentor or more of your a guide when it comes to the industry. And of course, I know with that, you'll be able to get there faster. You'll be the three steps or the four steps in general will be much easier for you if you have some guide or you have some direction when it comes to implementation. So cheers, guys. Peace.